writing regular villains can be a difficult process, writing a truly terrifying and horrifying villain can be even more difficult. In today's video, I want to talk about how you can create truly terrifying villains in your mangas, comics, and novels and make them characters that not only scare the characters in your story, but also scare your audience through the page. If you don't already know me, my name is Nora Cross, and on this channel, I dedicate all my videos to helping you turn your manga into a masterpiece. If you're new to my channel, please consider hitting that little subscribe button. It really helps support me and my channel, and it also ensures that you never miss a new video. So my first tip for creating a truly terrifying villain is to give them a lack of empathy. When you're looking at any kind of terrifying villain character in literature, you will notice that a common trait of these terrifying villains is the fact that they don't have any empathy for the other characters around them. Empathy is the way we care about other people. It's the way we feel and recognize their feelings and support their feelings. Where regular villains in a story might have some degree of empathy, a truly terrifying villain would likely not have any empathy at all. And that's how they manage to do all of these bad things, because they don't really think about the way other characters feel. They don't recognize that because they don't have empathy. And they might put a facade on the surface and pretend they do, but it's likely that under the surface they just don't really feel that way. A lack of empathy is truly terrifying, because once you give your villain character a lack of that, they will end up not really caring about what happens to the other characters around them. My second tip for creating a truly terrifying villain is to make them the hero of their own story. The people reading your book and you as the author will know that the protagonist is the true hero of your story. However, when you're creating a villain character, a villain who is truly scary and truly terrifying, you have to understand that that villain is actually going to see themselves as the hero of the story. Whatever your villain character does in your story, no matter how bad it is, they still need to believe that they are the good guy and what they're doing is right. And by making them the hero of their story, it provides this terrifying aspect to their character. For example, if your character was a very bad serial killer, they might feel like they have a good reason for doing what they do. They might feel like they are ridding the world of bad people, for example, in the case of Light Yagami from Death Note, where he used Death Note to get rid of criminals in the world. So in order to turn a villain into a truly terrifying character, you need to make them do something that is morally bad, but make them believe that it is something good. And by turning them into the hero of their own story, making them see themselves as the good guy, make them see themselves as the hero, that is when you shift that villain character into someone truly terrifying. And then no matter what they do, no matter how bad it is, they're still going to think that they are doing it for a good reason, even though it is not a good thing they are doing at all. My third tip is humanize them at the start. When creating a regular villain, I would recommend adding smaller moments about the story to really humanize them. However, in this video, we're talking about creating a truly terrifying villain. And so in the case of creating a truly bad villain, I'd only recommend humanizing them at the very start of the story. And when you do this, when you humanize them at the start and slowly turn them into this monstrous character over the story, it makes them far more terrifying because they started with very normal origins. Now, when you give your villain character a backstory, it can also really help if you show the root of their current villainous side in their backstory. So for a character who is abusive in the current times of the story, in the backstory when you reveal that, you might show that that character was also abused in their earlier years. And that's what humanizes them, that's what shows what they've been through. But then over time, after going through all that, when they become a villain, they feel strong by abusing others. The tables have turned and they have now become this character. Your villain character definitely would not have always been a villain. They would have had a moment in their past where they were also human too. And that's what makes it far more scary when they become a truly terrifying villain, because they weren't always this way. They were turned into this way by their events, by people around them, and by situations they went through. They became this villain. Griffith from Berserk, who in my opinion is one of the most terrifying villains in manga, he also comes from very normal origins. Due to his victories and war, he one day wants to have his own kingdom. That dream slowly changes him until he was willing to sacrifice everything for that dream, with no remorse for the consequences. So the key to creating a truly terrifying villain is to give them an origin story that makes them like anyone else, and then that really shows that any character has the potential to become a villain depending on their own experiences and what they have been through. My fourth tip is focus on the mental weaponry over the physical weaponry. Keep in mind that when creating a villain, they don't actually have to be physically strong strong, so they don't have to be super muscular or they don't have to have very powerful weapons in order to be a bad villain. In fact, some of the worst villains out there are villains that are simply mentally abusive or manipulative, and that can actually be far more terrifying than a character who can be physically formidable. The scariest types of villains are actually the ones that can get into the reader's minds. They are the ones that manipulate and lie and deceive over the story, and they might even convince the protagonist of your book to believe that they are a good person. These villain characters are very stealthy at what they do, and they can really deceive and manipulate the people around them in order to believe what they want. And yes, you can have a mix of both, of course. You can have a character who is physically formidable, who might be strong and might be able to use weapons, but also balance that with a character who is also mentally formidable as well. A character who knows about the psychological mind, and they can use that knowledge to control the people around them. They need to be the types of characters who can really get into the readers and the characters' minds, because the mind can actually be one of the scariest weapons of all. My fifth tip is show proof of their realistic threat. If you want to make your villain into someone truly scary, you need to actually show your audience how scary they actually are. If you're constantly just saying what your villain character does, saying that they did all these bad things, but never actually show it, it's going to be very hard to convince your audience that this villain is someone bad. So you really need to show them how far your villain character would be willing to go to get what they want. For example, if your villain is a serial killer, you would have to show them killing one of the major characters in your story in order to really show how much of a threat they are to the characters in your book. If your villain is someone who is more mentally abusive, then you would need to have a character in your book who is a result of that abuse. You need to show what that character has been through as a result of your villain character's constant manipulation and mental abuse. Show that in this character, they may get nervous or quiet every time your villain character is present. In any case, you really need to show your audience how bad your villain actually is. You need to provide proper evidence to it to help your audience understand, because if you're just telling your audience, then it's going to be a lot harder for your readers to believe it. But if you provide them actual realistic evidence and you show the results of what your villain has done on the characters around them, you show it through what the characters do in their daily lives, then it's going to make it far more realistic when you reveal your villain's true purpose in your book. My sixth tip is show their effect to the other characters around them. Terrifying villains are not this way to every single character, and they will likely treat different characters in very different ways depending on what they want to gain from each of those people. What makes them truly scary is when they are a villain to certain people and when they are a good character to other people. To put this into context, a character who commits crimes in the evenings may be someone who keeps up a facade of being someone kind and popular in the daytime. I think Joe Goldberg from the book You is a great example of this, because he is very, very skilled at keeping a facade around him. Everyone else seems to believe he is a great person. He has learned to act around others in order to make himself someone likable. Now, I think Sang-woo from Killing Stalking is also a great example of this, because what makes him so terrifying is the fact that he puts on a happy and energetic facade around others. He is popular, intelligent, and kind, and even the protagonist of the story fell for this deceit. Yet under the surface, he is extremely psychopathic, abusive, and dangerous. So to make your villain someone truly terrifying, you need to consider their effect on the people around them. You need to consider who really sees them as a villain and who might see them as a good guy. And when you change the way characters perceive your villain, it really shows how deceitful your villain is, how good they are at controlling the other people around them and making people see what they really want them to see. Some people might know your villain's true personality and completely fear them and want to stay away from them. And other people might see your villain's facade and want to be around your character, and they may even idolize your villain for their fake persona. My seventh tip is give them their own false reality. Truly terrified villains actually might live in their own false kind of world. People perceive the world in very different ways. However, a villainous character might actually have their own perception of the world, and they will likely not see it in the same way other people do. When certain people act in certain ways around them, they might actually manipulate the way they perceive those events in order to make it fit the reality around them. For example, your villain might live in a false reality where they believe everyone really likes them and idolizes them. And so when someone does not match their reality, they might push away that character. So if someone says, "You're a bad character and I don't want to be around you," because that does not fit their reality of their beliefs of people idolizing them, they might push that character away and not associate with that character anymore. Or if your villain character has someone around them that does idolize them, they would likely keep that person closer because that person fits their identical reality, and they would want to keep people around them who match their reality and their perception of the world. They accept those who accept their reality, and they push out or manipulate those who do not. They keep going with these types of behaviors until they live in a reality that they feel they can control and manipulate. So for your villains, when you're creating a truly scary villain, give them their own perception of the world around them. Consider, how does your villain really see that world around them, and what would they do to keep that reality in check? As the story progresses, give them more and more events that challenge their false perception of the world, and see what happens when your villain tries to stand up for their false perceptions and manipulate the characters around them to match their perfect reality. My 8th tip is make them unbeatable. When it comes to creating a regular villain, your characters might believe that they could defeat them with training and with practice. They might be able to stop this bad villain and bring back peace to the world. However, when you have a truly terrifying villain, they have to be someone so bad and terrifying that your protagonist believes they could never hope to defeat this bad villain. And it could be that the villain is someone very formidable. They may be someone who is very strong and powerful. They may have a lot of people working with them. They may have really powerful weapons. However, keep in mind that your villain character could also be someone mentally formidable as well. If your villain character is someone who is mentally controlling to the people around them, mental abuse is something very, very hard for your characters to break out of. If your character was constantly mentally abused by this villain, it's going to be very, very hard for them to feel like they can stand up for themselves and stand up against this villain after all this control that the villain has over them. Of course, your villain can also be someone who is a mix of someone who is mentally and physically formidable, and that makes them very, very hard to defeat. Your readers would likely really want to see your protagonist defeat this villain, but your readers and your characters should also see that defeating this bad villain should be something that is very, very difficult. You need to make it almost impossible for this villain to be defeated. There should be a way to defeat your very scary villain, of course, but it shouldn't be something that's easily found. It should be very, very difficult for your readers and characters to understand how they could defeat this very bad character. My 9th tip is give them likable qualities. There's a fine line between creating a villainous character who is hated and a villainous character who is feared. So to keep the balance between creating a character who is feared but also a well-written character, you need to give them some traits that humanize them in your reader's eyes. For example, your villainous character might be someone who is sarcastic and witty, and that makes them very funny and entertaining to read about. Even though they're absolutely terrifying, still, they're still entertaining to read about because of their wit and their sarcasm. Or in the case of Light Yagami from Death Note, they might be very intelligent and very smart about what they do, and that makes them very entertaining to read about because your audience will want to see how exactly they will plan out their next ideas. They may even just have common interests that most people reading your book might have, and that causes your readers to like them. It doesn't have to be a whole heap of things, and your villainous character should still stay someone villainous. However, you should still add a few little personality traits or things that do that make them more likable and entertaining as characters. And in this way, your readers won't hate to read about them. Your readers will still enjoy reading about them, but it also keeps them a scary character for your audience. My 10th tip is give them a strong goal that drives them. In order to make your villain interesting and help them to remain that way over the course of your book, you need to give them a strong goal. Because your villain shouldn't be someone who has no reason behind their actions. Every character should have some reason behind their actions, no matter how crazy or messed up the reasoning is. So even if your villain is someone truly terrifying and they have a really morally bad reason behind what they do, they still need to have a solid goal that keeps them taking action throughout your story and makes it realistic for them to do so. The goal needs to be something very important to them. However, the key here to turn them into a terrifying villain is that this goal needs to be so important that it would make them do whatever it takes to achieve that goal, even these really bad villainous things. In Griffith's case, his goal was to have his own kingdom, yet that goal warped, and in order to achieve it, he did some truly horrible things. In the case of other villains, they will do whatever it takes to achieve their goals, no matter how bad or messed up they have to be to get there. The goal needs to drive them to commit the crimes that make them into the truly scary villain of your story. My 11th tip is add an unsettling aspect to their appearance. You have to find a balance between making your villainous characters looking normal and looking scary, and to do this I recommend adding an uncanny aspect to their appearance, something that makes them look a little strange or a little different from the other characters in your book. In Griffith's case, it was his unnatural beauty that made him unsettling, because he looked so beautiful and so perfect, and yet he did so many bad things. For Sang-woo, it's not only the slight smile he sometimes has, but also those cold, empty eyes. For a villain, it doesn't even have to be an attribute of their face, but a way they act. Their eyes may linger on certain things for too long. They may smile in the wrong situations at the wrong times. It doesn't have to just be appearance either. They could have a certain habit that makes them unsettling because it is repeated so much. They might like to touch a pocket knife they have at repeated times throughout the day, or they might repeat a similar motion that is a reoccurrence in their villainous character. As you can see, your villain's personality and appearance are also very important to keep in mind, because even before you fully reveal your villain's true purpose, your audience could still look at your villainous character and they might see these little subconscious points that you have added in your character's personality and appearance, and it might give them the hint that your villainous character is someone who should not be trusted before you fully reveal that. The 12th tip is choose their deadly sin. You will actually notice that some of the most well-written villains actually have one of the 7 deadly sins most prominent in their personality, so I think it's very good to refer to this as you're writing your characters, and choose one of the 7 deadly sins to really base your villain's most villainous sides around. Some might be driven by greed or envy or pride, and by choosing this, it can really help you to narrow down your villain's personality and help them to be more easy to write. In this way, you can continue to focus on the main aspect of their personality and not lose track on it. Once you have that idea and concept in mind, it's going to make it a lot easier for you to write and develop them as characters. These 7 deadly sins are lust, gluttony, greed, sloth, wrath, envy, and pride. Adding these traits to your villain characters when you are developing them can help them become more well-written and entertaining as characters. The 13th tip is consider their breaking point. Every character has a breaking point, but for a truly scary villain, this breaking point could result in some very bad aspects of their personality coming to the surface. So you really need to consider when you're developing a truly terrifying villain, consider what really makes them break and turn into a much more terrifying character than before. What really topples them over the edge? We talked about earlier in this video how your villainous characters will likely put on a false facade to the people around them. Well, when your villain character breaks, this whole facade will crumble and it will show their true personality. So that's why it's so important to consider what their breaking point is, because that is the moment when they shift from being someone who might appear normal into someone who is a true villain. When your villain has their breaking point, it might vary depending on what kind of villain they are. They might lash out or get angry at the people around them. They might suddenly reveal aspects of their personality they didn't before. They might even just have a bit of a breakdown and they might just need a moment where they need to be alone for a while. Your villain's breaking point will be different for every kind of character, but it's highly important to consider this because it's a very important aspect of their personality, and it really is the moment where they reveal their weaknesses and they reveal what really makes them hurt inside. And my 14th and final tip for creating a truly terrifying villain is make them the shadow side of the protagonist. What I recommend you do is you look at your protagonist in your book and you write down the traits of your protagonist that makes them most prominently them. For example, your protagonist might be someone who is good, who is kind, who is humble, who is determined. Once you have a list of your protagonist's most prominent traits, write down beside them the opposite traits of your protagonist. These are the traits that should be most prominent in your villainous character. In order to make them a villain character that is so terrifying to the main characters and your audience, your villain character should reflect aspects of your protagonist that are hidden under the surface. Essentially, they should be the shadow side of the protagonist. For example, your protagonist may be the kind of person who wants to help others. They may spend their time saving people and helping others, and that's something that's really important in their personality and their character story. The opposite of that is cruelty. When you're creating a villainous character, they would likely want to hurt the characters around them and cause problems, and that is the opposite of what your protagonist would do in this example. So if you are struggling to create your villainous characters, consider who your protagonist is and make your villain someone who is opposite in personality to your protagonist. And in this way, you can create that kind of contradiction. And when your characters conflict so much, it makes them far more terrifying as a villain. And it really reveals both your characters' unique traits and really shows it more boldly to your audience. Your antagonist reflects the underlying aspects of your protagonist's personality, and when they reveal that on a more extreme level, it can turn them into a far more terrifying character, not only to the other characters in your book, but also to your readers as well. Thank you so much for watching my video today, everyone. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please let me know in the comment section down below. Let me know what kind of villain characters you're creating in your books, because I'd love to hear about them. Feel free to chat with me on any of my social media at NurseCross, because I always enjoy hearing about the projects that you're creating. Again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!